The objective of this video is to show you the practical differences between IP CCTV systems and AHD CCTV systems. We will specifically be looking at four major areas where there are differences. Number one, we will be comparing IP cameras to AHD cameras and we'll state the differences. Number two, we'll be comparing their recording systems, that is NVR versus DVR, and how they are different from each other. Number three, we'll be looking at the type of cables used in both systems and the connectors that are fitted on the cables. And finally, number four, we'll be looking at the power supply unit required for AHD cameras and also that of IP cameras. It promises to be very informative. Please ensure you watch to the end. Let's start by comparing the cameras, that is AHD versus IP cameras. All the cameras you see here are all AHD cameras. The unique feature used in identifying that these cameras are analogue or AHD cameras is the B and C connector on the terminal of each of these cameras. You can see that all these cameras have the B and C connector aside the DC power connector, and so we can conclude that all these cameras are analogue or AHD cameras. Here are IP cameras on the other hand. The unique identifying feature on IP cameras is the Ethernet connection jack on their terminal, unlike analog cameras that have B and C. So we can say that the camera can be identified by examining the terminals to determine whether it is an IP camera or an AHD or analog camera. Let's now compare their video recorders. Please note that the recording system for IP CCTV systems is called an NVR, that is network video recorder, whilst the recorder and video processing system for AHD or analog CCTV systems is called a DVR, that is digital video recorder. This is a DVR or a video recording system for an analog or AHD camera system. DVRs come with BNC inputs through which analog or AHD cameras are connected, and you will not find this on an NVR. The number of the BNC inputs is what is used to tell the number of cameras the DVR can take. There are capacities of 4, 8, 16, 24, 32 input or channel DVRs. This is an NVR. Typical of an NVR, unlike a DVR, comes with Ethernet port or ports through which IP cameras are connected. There are NVRs such as this one that you have on your screen that have just one Ethernet port, in which case a PoE switch will be used together with that kind of NVR for the connection of the cameras. There are also NVRs that come with multiple Ethernet ports, such as the one you can see here, whereby the IP cameras are directly connected to the NVR without having to take the cameras through a PoE switch. Let's now look at the connecting cables and the kind of connectors used on the cables for both systems. This is a coaxial cable. It is the most appropriate cable for the connection of AHD or analog CCTV cameras for effective video transmission from the cameras to the video recorder. The ends of the coaxial cable are fitted with BNC connectors. Here are samples of BNC connectors. There are other designs of the BNC connectors, but ultimately, their point of connection to the camera and the DVR all look the same. Please note that the coaxial cable is responsible for only video transmission from the camera to the DVR. A separate power cable is used to connect power to analog cameras. The power cables are fitted with DC power connectors at the point where the cable enters into the camera. Here are samples of such DC power connectors. On your screen now is a cable called Siamese cable. This cable is a combination of a coaxial cable and power supply cable that are put together into a single unit cable. This cable helps to reduce the burden of having to lay two separate cables, one for power and another for video, for just one AHD or analog camera installation. IP CCTV camera systems, on the other hand, use Cat6 network cables or Cat5 network cables. The Cat5 or Cat6 cable is able to carry both video and power along the same cable, and this means that once this cable is used, it caters for both video transmission from the camera into the NVR and also for power transmission from the PoE switch to the camera. Let's now look at power supply sources for IP cameras and also for AHD cameras. Here is a typical power supply unit used for AHD or analog CCTV cameras. It contains terminal blocks, such as you can see, on which camera power supply terminals are wired. Each of these blocks take a camera each, and so you will have to select this unit based on the number of cameras you are installing. IP cameras, on the other hand, are either powered through a separate power over Ethernet switch, or they are powered through NVRs with power over Ethernet ports created on them. Please note that the fact that you can view your CCTV camera system online does not make it an IP system. In fact, both systems, either IP CCTV system or AHD CCTV system, can be viewed online or on any mobile device when the right settings are in place. Thanks so much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel.